The South Dakota State football team is 4-2 overall, 1-1 in the Missouri Valley Football Conference. After rallying from a 28-10 second quarter deficit to defeat the Missouri State Bears Saturday night 32-28.
Very proud of the Jacks, proud of the how they handled the adversity. Not excited about the adversity we created ourselves, but we're going to address that. And unless we focus on it, we're going to put ourselves in that situation again, so we need to take care of it.
Quarterback Zach Luham was actually pulled from the game in the second quarter for a series. He responded by throwing for over 300 yards and three touchdowns in the come-from-behind victory.
Well, yeah, the quarterback position is not one you rotate guys in, at least we don't. And there were a lot of things that went into making that decision. And in the end, it was the right decision. I think Zach rose up and handled the game from there. And our offense rose up, and so I think we made the right decision. I am very pleased with Zach, and I expect him to get better every week. I expect myself to get better every week. It's part of our program, but I'm excited we have him, and I'm excited about his leadership, and I know he's going to make a lot of plays for us.
And when you talk the quarterback position at SDSU, it always comes around to Austin Sumner. The senior from Brandon, who was hurt in the opening game of the year, was cleared to get rid of his walking boot earlier on last week and was standing on the sideline Saturday. However, he is still trying to rehabilitate from that injury, and Stiglmeyer says that's an ongoing process.
Austin's injury is, I think, coming along very well. He's doing some underwater running, which takes the pressure off. So how long, when, I have no clue.
Redshirt freshman wide receiver Jake Winicky starred for the Jackrabbits on Saturday night. Just days after being named to the Jerry Rice Award watch list, that goes to the top freshman in the FCS, the Minnesotan caught 8 passes for 183 yards and 3 touchdowns.
Well, he has come out of the chute full speed, and he's got the confidence. He's surely got the ability. We've been in some situations where we've maybe thrown the ball more than we thought we were going to, and he's benefited from that. But bottom line is, he's a great football player. And at his age, my expectation is he becomes even greater as the year go on.
And Zach Zenner now ranks in the top 10 in FCS history in career rushing. He ran for 149 yards and a touchdown that was the game winner in Saturday's affair against Missouri State.
Well, Zach Zenner is a phenomenal football player, and he's benefited from an offense that wants to run the ball, and he's great at running the ball. He's had good support around him, but seldom does he get stopped. The first time, first contact, his desire, his work ethic, his knowledge of the game. He's a special football player for the Jacks.
Now it's on to Northern Iowa in Cedar Falls on Saturday afternoon. The Panthers are 3-3, but you consider their only FCS loss a 1-point defeat at Indiana State. And they've lost 2 games by a total of 12 points to FBS competition at Iowa and Hawaii.
Northern Iowa is a good football program. It doesn't matter what the score is. They're a good football program. They're at home. It's a hostile environment. Coach Farley will have them ready. They're very skilled. They're very physical. They do a lot of things offensively and defensively. So it's going to be a tough game on the road, Missouri Valley.
And UNI's leading offensive player is David Johnson, the All-America candidate, has rushed for 564 yards and 2 touchdowns already this year.
David Johnson is an excellent football player. He's ranked as an NFL prospect, probably catches the ball more than Zach Zenner does. Not the same type of runner, but a big, powerful guy.
The Panthers may be 3-3 overall, but they are 2-0 at home, averaging better than 12,000 per game inside the raucous environment that is the Unidome.
Well, it is, and you would hope if you're a good football program, there's a home field advantage, both in you being at home and your home crowd, and UNI has that. UNI, I think, through the years, is probably the most successful Gateway/Missouri Valley football program there's been.
Perhaps the biggest key for SDSU going into Saturday's Valley tilt at Northern Iowa is simply getting healthy. The squad had already been besieged by injuries and added a couple more to that total on Saturday night.
Yeah, I've never been one to whine or to focus on injuries, but it's taken its toll in our program, and we will get some guys back, I think, a little healthier. Will we be 100%? Will we be where we need to be? Yes, but we do have some guys injured.